Okay, so you might really wonder what really is IVF. That's a fancy-sounding word, in vitro fertilization. So some of you may already know what it is because you might have studied this or even gone through some cycles, but that might have been confusing to you. But I'm just going to start from scratch. The simplest way of showing what IVF is that we put, and this is a test tube. It's not a culture dish. It's a test tube. But we just put sperm and eggs together in a test tube. Fertilization takes place naturally. And then 2 or 3 days later, the embryo is taken out of culture and is put back into the woman. In other words, this is the classic test tube baby. It shouldn't be so frightening because really the baby doesn't develop in the test tube. We're just trying to get fertilization to take place and to know it's going to take place properly. And so the test tube is the easiest place to do it, but it's really a natural pregnancy. And so you see with this diagram here, the embryo or the embryos are put back into your uterus within a matter of days. So it's just a normal, natural pregnancy, but it was initiated by making sure that the sperm fertilized the eggs. Now to do that, you're going to be on the woman will be on these hormones that will assure that we get the best quality eggs at exactly the right time. Everything's timed precisely. The sperm will be carefully washed so that we have no poor quality sperm. And so then we know that we have absolute assurance of fertilization because we've timed everything perfectly and we've got the best quality eggs. And then those embryos are put back into the uterus. Now, you've heard there's a problem. When the man has a low sperm count, usually that's not so terrible. But if his sperm count is very low, extremely low, then those sperm won't fertilize. They will not fertilize in the egg, in the dish anyway. If we have poor quality sperm and a very low number of sperm, you will get fertilization failure, even in a test tube. And in fact, often with sperm that looked just great in a man with a normal sperm count, maybe 2% to 5% of the time, those beautiful looking sperm still won't fertilize. So what we do to make sure that you will have fertilization in the modern era, and this procedure was first brought to the U.S. at St. Luke's. St. Luke's is where it was first performed in the U.S. and St. Luke's and also the Brussels, Belgium, Dutch-speaking Free University, where we worked together, were the first places to do this, and now it's swept the world. But it's called ICSI, a funny word, but that ICSI means that we pick up an individual sperm that we know is a normal sperm, and we inject it into an egg that we know is a mature egg because we can tell by what's called a polar body that's been extruded from this egg that all the hormones we gave to the woman have worked. And, you know, not all eggs are normal. We pick just the normal eggs, and we inject that with the sperm so that we make sure we guarantee fertilization will take place. So this way, it's not a matter of chance. Maybe the sperm count's too low. Maybe the sperm quality isn't so good, even though all of our testing of the sperm looks okay. We don't have any doubt like that. We don't have to worry. We know fertilization will take place. And we have so much experience at St. Luke's since 1993 in doing ICSI that we've studied this carefully, and there is no harm to any of these eggs related to the injection of the sperm. It just assures fertilization, and there really is no risk or danger to it.